Good afternoon. My name is Al Fierce Marks, community advocate here in New York City. Today, I want to discuss the issues of the pacification of our community. Right now, we're dealing with, lawmakers, as well as other elected officials that want to stay in office, so they want to give us meaningless rhetorics and relics to try and soothe the pressure that's going on now within mainstream media. They want to paint streets in controversial areas, as well as within our communities, of Black Lives Matter. But the matter is, does the Black Lives really matter to these elected officials? We're going to talk about that today. As you know, there's been a push by not just local elected officials, but federal elected officials to remove statues, paint streets, as well as talk and engage in discussion of Black Lives Matter, when they've known all this time that it's the laws that actually matter to bring about change and to make people feel the way they need to feel, opposed to taking out some of these statues and painting some of these streets. Street paintings and everything means nothing. Why does it mean nothing? Because it doesn't put an emphasis on the actual lawmakers caring about our community. And when I say care about our community, I mean, look at the educational system here in New York City. Our children, young Black scholars, have to face inequalities of education. These school systems today are segregated, like they've always been. And people have missed the actual calling for what's necessary for our kids to flourish and compete within society. What does this mean? This means that when we look at our children, we look at the education that they receive, it's not the same as what it is that white children get. When we look at the past news on these issues of segregation, they've limited our children just to specialized schools. My question has always been this here. If our children can't pass the test to get into these specialized schools, what makes anyone feel that they can actually be productive in these specialized schools and graduate? We have to look at them. We have to be aware of these things, because setting us children up with these meaningless pacifications, we set them up to fail, because we're not giving them the tools that's necessary. And when we look at it all, even the state of New York has adopted a system designed to promote our children, regardless whether they know the information or not, based off their age. So they're really doing a disservice to our children. They're really telling our children that their lives really don't matter, because if they can't get the actual educational requirements for a community level college, they become a product of their environment. And being a product of the environment doesn't mean that they go into the streets, though some do, but it means that they will be forced to work 2 and 3 jobs. And working 2 and 3 jobs in an economy such as this, it doesn't actually benefit us. So we're going to talk about that. What does it take for us to desegregate the schools? What does it take for us to actually be reconditioned to believing and enforcing that our lives actually matter? The violence, the lack of resources, the lack of commitment to us, by us. These are the issues that we must face. When you speak about laws, the only laws that can actually help us to build, bridge that gap is education, is financial institutions, access to us. Without that, our lives really don't matter. And if our lives don't matter to us, then what ends up taking place is we start to continue to oppress I won't.
Turn the point.
We start to actually engage of blaming everybody else except for blaming ourselves for the responsibility aspects of holding our elected officials accountable. Many of us don't believe that our elected officials are responsible for some of the things that's going on within our communities, so they give them a pass. And that's not correct. That's not right. We've seen a street paint down on 57th Street in front of Trump's office. We've been having this problem about Black Lives Matter and our elected officials and state lawmakers before Trump was even in office. But yet they want to continue that cycle of holding that person accountable when it's all said and done. We've always had this issue. They just recently painted a memorial of Black Lives Matter in the Bronx. Painted it on Morris Avenue, I personally felt that it should have been painted in front of the Bronx District Attorney's Office. Because when you look at the Bronx District Attorney's Office, they have continuously misled our communities. They have continually failed our communities. They have purposely, due to their professional relationship with police departments, refused to hold any form of accountability for these killings. And in doing so, we've had no justice, no peace, and we've yet to see justice. But yet, we're pacified to have peace. We must hold our elected officials accountable. We must stop all this rhetoric, changes. We must stop engaging in, yes, let's tear down these statues. As though some believe that these statues are a signification of white supremacy, the signification comes in the form of the education books, which continues to mislead our children. Because these same people are in the history books that's being taught. So we can't accept one, right, and deny or ignore the other. We must fight for education. We must fight for the reconditioning of our children. We must fight for the fact that these leaders who claim to be our leaders are not doing what it is they're supposed to do. And that's where it needs to be. We need to start engaging ourselves. We need to start becoming one with ourselves. We must start ignoring the pacifications and get down to the nitty-gritty. And these nitty-gritties begin with holding the fire at the feet of these politicians, of our elected officials. We can no longer afford to have individuals mislead us by getting us to paint streets. Because if we painted those same streets without the elected officials, we'd be charged with a fee. So if it really mattered, if it really was supposed to be about seeing these signs and having pride, they wouldn't criminalize the graffiti artist who does it. So beware of the traps. And these traps, I can honestly tell you, is designed for us to forget about the main issue. The main issue that we face is education, because we can't compete without education. The main issue is doing away with the disparities in pay when it comes down to blacks and whites. Because as it stands right now, blacks make 60% of the dollar amount that whites make. And when I say whites, I mean white men. And then it's the white woman, then it's the black and Hispanic man. That's that 60% behind those two. So we must be diligent, we must be informative with one another. We can no longer afford to take advantage of what's there with, how can I say it, ignorance. And when I speak about ignorance, I mean having doubt about the authenticity of something that's actual facts. We can no longer utilize that excuse of, how do we know that's true? How can we be sure that it's true? We can no longer be dependent. We must start becoming independent. And being independent is thinking for our communities and doing for our communities and making sure that our communities benefit as a people. We had a conversation maybe last week about integration and segregation, and that day just didn't go well. As I left off, the question is why? Why are we so conditioned to getting our own agendas with pacifications. One, we can look into our communities itself and see how some of the leaders, and when I speak about the leaders, I mean the church leaders, so-called community leaders, political leaders, they all have an agenda where they really treated our communities like a business. We are considered commodities. It's like a farm with just the cows waiting to be slaughtered for production, for wholesale within some of these supermarkets. That plays a big difference within our everyday living. Because when they teach our children, when they teach our communities, what's missing is the quality of living, the quality of life, our livelihoods, the way that we work to sustain the norm, the way we actually look at things and normalize them. We've dealt with disparities of treatment for so long that we haven't actually challenged why and why it continues to take place. And one of the things that we have to do, we must get rid of our leaders. We must form new leaders. We must have new alliance to those that's solely content with making sure that our communities get what's necessary. You look at the churches. Again, the majority of churches want money. And they don't care about our communities because it shows. They're in our communities, they're doing nothing. They're in our communities and they're providing any services besides church services. They're in our communities, they're not helping our communities. They're cozying up with elected officials. The same thing with some of our communities. They're more content with getting photo ops with local officials, that they don't press the local officials on the issues that affect our communities. They literally have taken on the mentality that we gotta start somewhere. Getting these statues and these paintings on the floors of the streets is a start. Start for who? Start for what? That's what we have to ask ourselves. Because we have been suffering from the same issues for the last 154 years. We have watched these issues persist over the last 56 years. Because Malcolm was telling us a long time ago that these so-called leaders were selling us out because they have hidden agendas. And if we sit back, we get away from the YouTubes, we get away from the reality TV series, we get away from the gossip, we get away from looking at what it is that makes us forget about our responsibilities, we'll see that nothing has changed. You know what I mean? And in the course of anything changing, the suffering has. And the fact that the suffering is taking place, what we wind up seeing is, guess what? How do we actually begin to implement what's necessary? We can't, as long as our minds are filled with rubbish. And this garbage that our minds are filled with, it doesn't translate to the future of our children benefit.